is Solar PV TV once again from Rest for Africa program launch here in Ethiopia, in Addis Ababa. And now we are very happy because we have together with us Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Mr. Gemedo Dale. So, hello.
Hello.
So, Mr. Dale, I was so happy, you know, when you were making these statements during the press conference that, first of all, Ethiopia can become like a renewable energy mama for Africa. But on the other hand, you said that you need to make this change together. So could you justify to our viewers in few points your point of view?
Thank you very much. Ethiopia is one of the few African countries that have clear strategy and also policy for development, a development that does not cost the opportunities and the rights of future generation. We have what we call the climate resilient green economy strategy, which we have already started implementing since 2011. It was launched in Durban, South Africa. And then in that strategy, in our development policy, our target is to develop through the clean and green development path, which is fully in line with, in agreement with the renewable energy generation policy. Mm-hmm. And in this context and also in other sectors, our development policy is to develop with our neighbors. And that is not only on the paper. We have already started joint development with our neighbors.
Like an action plan?
Yeah. Not only action plan. We have already in the implementation. Just to give you one example, we have tried to create economic integration with Djibouti, because if our neighbors are not developing at equal pace with us, then it won't be sustainable. And one of the challenge for Africa and one of the practical problem we are facing is lack of opportunity for our citizens in the region. So if we create opportunities, balanced development opportunities in our neighboring countries, then we will have peace, we will have security, we will have joint plan which we implement together. And another example I could mention is the infrastructure development with Kenya. In our plan to have economic integration again with Kenya, we have started highway construction, and in our side that has been completed, and on the Kenyan side is also almost near to completion. And also we are trying to link the electric power generated from the Renaissance Dam to the Kenyan side, and that is also underway. In that year, what I am trying to say is, we have a very clear and very inclusive policy that we need to develop, and when we develop, we need to develop with our neighbors and create economic integration for prosperity of our nations.
So not only just like a renewable energy mama, but more like a renewable energy family, yes?
Yes. Yeah, that's how we are planning. And renewable energy is one very important
key element
because we are trying to transform our economy from agriculture-led to industry-led. Then when industries come, particularly when there are many in the diverse, in manufacturing and others, and then we need more energy for running the business. And also we need energy for other purposes, like market opportunity in the region. That, and as we said, we have huge potential within the country, and we want to maximize that potential in generating hydroelectric power, wind power, geothermal power, and solar, and rural electrification is one of our targets. But again, in the grid, we want to link this opportunity with our neighbors and create market in the region.
But you forgot one thing. You forgot that you have also so great human resources.
Yes, that's true. And the human capacity within the country, in the region, is very amazing. But opportunities are limited. Our experts, our youngsters are going to the university, but we need to train them in a way that they remain productive, efficient, competitive at the global market. And so to make that happen and to change that in reality, then we need more focused training, particularly in different sectors so that they are not only capable of doing things in Africa, but also at the global level.
Also, I liked very much your point when you were saying that you don't need so much aid, but you need actually contribution from the partners. Yes, could you elaborate on that?
Yes, Africa in general, and Ethiopia in particular, is very much interested in having investment in the country for the mutual benefit, following mutual trust, mutual benefit, and also having clear policies in place, and also working together for the
to build the future together.
And in this context, then what we are much more interested in is not getting aid in a continuous basis. Yes, there are times when we need aid, like in the case of drought, in the case of natural catastrophes, but it should not remain as such. We need private sector to come in with investment, our development partners with investment, and that is the future for Africa, that is the future for Ethiopia, and we are running away. I mean, we would like to come out of that box of aid, overseas development.
We have cooperation, business models that everybody is a winner, yes?
Cooperation with aid at the core needs to be replaced by cooperation with investment at the core.
Okay. So how would you imagine, because we are at the event of Race for Africa, how do you imagine further cooperation between your ministry and Race for Africa initiative?
Fortunately, we have all policy guidelines, strategy, and action plans, and 5-year plan in place. What's remaining is to start implementing. So the vision of Race for Africa, the vision of all partners behind Race for Africa, the members, is perfectly in line with our domestic legislation. So for us, it's a matter of starting the business. There could be some minor fixings, but in general, we are ready for that implementation. Our policy is very suitable for investors, and we call upon investors and our development partners to use Ethiopia as a case show where you can see very transformative change on ground that would benefit the African continent.
It's because a dream without action and implementation only remains a dream. And I hope we'll meet next year, yes? At the next Race for Africa event. Thank you so much. Thank you.